Shots fired.
Shots fired.
It was my 22nd birthday, and I was coming off of having pneumonia. If you're in college, people don't care at all if you were sick or not. You're gonna go out if people are gonna make you do shots. And basically what happened is that I blacked out. I woke up the next morning in my apartment, no purse, no cell phone, no keys, wearing some dude's shirt with a note card that said John and a phone number. I don't know what's going on, but I have to try and piece this together. I look in the mirror, I have a black X on my cheek, and I look down at my hand, I had been X'd out of the bar because that's what they do if you've had too much to drink and they wanna make sure that you don't get served anymore. I had two, like I got double X'd the f out. So that means I must have ended up at Dave's bar. So I start retracing my blacked out steps. I walk in, the DJ is standing there with my purse, my coat, my phone. Looks like you had a good night, huh? I don't wanna talk about it. I'm still drunk, so. Like my phone is full of texts. Everybody thinks I'm dead in a ditch somewhere. And one of these texts is from this grad student who is also a professor. He was gorgeous. All of a sudden, my memory starts to like flood back to me. I'm dancing in the giant black cages. The grad student standing at the bar. I come down from the cages and, you know, in my head then like fans turn on and I'm like Beyonce and just ready to like change his world, but in reality I'm like, you know, like can't even keep my eyes open. I have drool coming down my face. I walked right up to him and grabbed him and just start like sloppy making out with him. Oh. Don't go anywhere. I'm gonna go to the bathroom. So this is where I've chosen to throw up. Like I'm hugging the toilet, throwing up on my arms. And then my brain was just like, okay, this is your bed now. Like now you sleep. So I end up there, that's all I remember. So once I recover my phone and my purse, I get back home, I call this number. A guy answers, hello, is this Kelsey? Yeah, I'm sorry, who are you? My name's John, I'm the manager of Johnny Joe's Sandwiches and I drove you home last night. Oh my God, I f***ed Johnny Joe. So apparently John, manager of Johnny Joe's, is on his smoke break when they carried me out of the bar. They're trying to find somebody to take me home at this point. I can take her, she probably doesn't live far, so I can do it. Now I'm inside of his brand new, beautiful truck. Within 5 seconds of starting that drive, projectile vomiting all over the inside of his truck. We get to my apartment and he realizes that I don't have my keys. I don't have anything with me. This man like Spider-Man'd into my apartment, brings me to my bathroom, puts me in front of the toilet so I can throw up more.
Come cuddle with me.
That's like so horrifying. I'm like, come cuddle with me. It is like covered in puke. So he's like, I don't want you to feel uncomfortable about this, but you've got puke all over your shirt. So he takes my shirt off. He puts his shirt on me. Poor John, he goes back to work shirtless. And anytime I tell this story, people are like, did you go on a date with John afterward? Like, he sounds like the nicest guy ever. I'm pretty sure I would have lost him at like, come cuddle with me with like a vomit bib. But I made him cookies. I don't know if that was enough. I feel like maybe I should have like given him a hand or something nicer, but thanks, John.